Middle Brow, known for its beers, is now adding to their roster natural wines.
Here with more on this and prepare a wine cocktail for us, Middle Brow partner Pete Ternes. Thank you so much for being here.
Yeah, thanks for having me. I was here 30 years ago for the Bozo show.
Oh, but, what?
Yeah,
did you actually?
I did. I made it on.
You made it on.
I got through 5 buckets, I think.
That's pretty impressive.
Wow.
Okay. Well, welcome back to the studio.
Yeah, thanks. It's great to be here.
And thanks for bringing cocktails.
Yeah,
yes. So tell us a little bit about Middle Brow. I mean, you guys are known for your beer, right?
Yeah. We started as a brewery, over 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. And we were contract brewing, and we're nomadic brewers for a long time. So we just popped around and made beer at various facilities and opened up our own brick and mortar spot in 2019.
And that's called Bungalow?
That's right, called Bungalow in Logan Square.
Okay.
Pizza became a big part of our identity, bread too. And we started making natural wines right around then in 2019, and it's really taking off now.
What does natural wine mean? Because in my head, it's grapes. Mm-hmm. They're all natural, right?
Yeah,
right?
Sure. Well, typically traditional wine can be filled with all sorts of things.
Okay.
Right? Winemakers don't have to put those things on the bottle so you don't know they're there. They affect the life cycle of the fermentation of the wine. They affect
meaning
the flavor.
Meaning like chemicals or additives?
Yeah. Lots of synthetic stuff.
And, okay.
You know, there's something called something that makes the wine look extra purple, extra red, or something that makes it taste like a Cabernet Sauvignon, No, we don't do any of that
stuff. Okay, I like
beautiful.
That.
The grapes taste like the grapes.
Yeah. And you're going to make a cocktail from one of your wines.
Yeah, we are. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so this cocktail, geez, it doesn't have a name. I suppose it does. It's a Michigan wine rattler.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The wine comes from Michigan, principally. Our wine comes from Michigan with a little bit of stuff from farmed in California as
I got it. Let's call it a daytime rattler.
Yeah, daytime rattler.
daytime.
I mean, that's what we're too old to drink at night anymore anyway.
Yeah.
Oh, not you guys.
We are the royal we.
All right, so we'll start with, an ounce and a half of gin, of course.
Okay.
This is by Leatherby, our buddies in the Northwest side.
Nice.
You want to keep things local. Keep it as local as possible, right? If the wine's local and our kombucha is house kombucha, keep everything else local too.
You're kind of like a fermenting house. The kombucha is something that's fermented yeast strains.
Yeah, sure. This is just
the kombucha.
A touch.
Oh, that was the kombucha.
This is just a touch of simple syrup. It's a little sugar.
Oh, sorry. Yeah,
just a little bit. Yeah. We'll put the recipe up. But
this
is. I should actually measure it. We're pretty loose with it. Oh.
No, you can just
pour
in.
Let me
think
about this. I'm doing it out of order.
Okay.
Next is our wine.
This one is
Cookout, a Zinfandel Rosé.
And it's so cute. The names are like Cookout and Pizza Wine.
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah.
We try to kind of. Remind people, where they should be drinking our stuff.
And it's got bubbles.
That's right. Yeah. A lot of our wines are sparkling. And
I like that.
Of course, the kombucha is sparkling, so this is a pretty bubbly drink. The kombucha is made by our brewer, Ed Brady, who's been with us for a long time.
Oh, great. So, the breads are like sourdoughs, so there's like all these active yeasts happening.
Yeah.
Everything is,
Fermentation is our thing. So beautiful. We're finishing this with kombucha. It's about 4.5 ounces to give you an 8-ounce drink, but, you can be a little bit, loose
beautiful.
With this.
Yeah.
So this I'll is just the kind kombucha. Of top it off, right?
Yep, and then I'm going to, as you've garnished that, I'm going to bring these up that you made prior.
Yeah, right. All right.
Should Amy and I try
that? You should try those ones.
And fantastic. Cheers.
Yeah, cheers.
Beautiful.
Cheers.
Congratulations.
It's a wine rather.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Wow.
That is good.
Very easy drinking.
Yeah.
That's good. And how many bottles of this natural wine do you guys have? We saw Cookout there, pizza wine.
Yeah, we've got pollen here as well. These are three of our, I think, 9 or 10 varietals and blends this year. So,
are you going to be changing those seasonally to reflect the flavors of the season?
Yeah. I think, we won't release everything at once just because not everything is quite right for the season or not every wine is, done.
Yeah.
Certain wines taste better when they're aged a little bit more mature. Others are, old age.
She and I are maturing.
Yeah.
And there's a theme here of kind of like letting these yeast strains go wild and ferment and do their own thing where you don't interfere. And so are your beers are along the same lines, right? What kind of beers?
Generally speaking, that's true. Yeah, we've always been kind of pursuing yeast forward brewing. So since we started, it was very kind of scary in the brewing world to brew wild beers and to brew yeast forward beers in the early teens, I suppose, 2011, 2012. But we tried it, and back then we didn't, we did okay.
Yeah.
But it took a few years, and now we hit our stride sometime in the middle of last decade, and things are great now. We also brew a ton of lagers, and that's a big part of our. If you come to our pizza place, lagers are a major feature too.
Do you use the same yeast in your beer that you use like in the pizza crust and the pizzas at the restaurant?
That's a great question. We toy with it, and sometimes we do little parties or special events where we kind of use a strain of a beer strain in in a loaf of bread or something.
Beautiful salads on your menu, pizzas, breads, fancy toasts. You guys do dinners, and then you do lunch on Fridays, brunches on the weekends.
That's right. Yeah.
You do tavern style pizza just on Tuesday.
That's right. That's taken off. That style of pizza. That's what I grew up with. I don't know if you're around here.
Yeah.
It's
you can't be from Chicago.
Yeah.
What's tap? It's like the really thin.
Super thin. We make it especially thin, like paper thin, and
when you can sit down and eat a whole pizza and not feel bad about it.
That's right. Yeah.
Well, and you can't stop yourself. It has to be cut into squares.
That's right. And the squares. Yes. We cut our squares like so small.
Oh, that was a little shot of it. Yeah.
Yeah. They're like an inch by an inch or something. So you just sit there snacking, and you're. Belly might not feel great if you don't control yourself, but yeah.
And I love that. And just real quick, you're always giving back to the community still, right?
We do our best, constantly trying. You know, when we started, it was bunch of our profits, almost all of our profits went to local social justice organizations. Now it's bread donations and various other community.
Love that.
That's awesome. Action.
Well, there is all the information for Middle Brow Beer and now Wine Company. Mm-hmm. It's over in Logan Square at 2840 West Armitage Avenue. And then you can find out more about them online, middlebrowbeer.com. And of course, they're on Instagram and all the social places too. Thanks for joining us, Pete.
Sure, thanks
so
for having
appreciate
me.
It.